Stocky Jockey coming at you from Natoli's Italian Deli in Secaucus, New Jersey. Today, Steve Natoli and I are going to be constructing a sandwich of truly heroic proportions. The Stocky Jockey. Ham, salami, pepperoni, cavatappi, prosciutini, provolone, fresh mozzarella. How amazing is the Stocky Jockey? It's all that. And a bag of chips. Whether you call it a hero or a sub, a hoagie, a grinder, or a torpedo, there's only one Stocky Jockey, and the original can only be found here at Natoli's.
Now, this is the size hero we make when Stocky Jockey's in the house, because he's just that kind of guy. He does everything in a big way. But if you come down to the store during the week and you just want to taste the Stocky Jockey, this will be on our menu for the rest of the time that Natoli's is in business. And here it is. This is the jumbo. You can get all the same ingredients and everything, but this bread and this size is reserved for Stocky Jockey. So I want to just give a little lesson on some cold cuts here, because it is important to have good quality Thumann's cold cuts, as well as a little bit of Hormel thrown in there, but mostly Natoli's is an exclusive Thumann's store. The first ingredient we like to talk about is the Genoa salami. This is Deluso Genoa salami. Deluso Genoa salami is the highest grade Genoa that you can buy, but the difference between Deluso Genoa and regular Genoa salami is the natural casing on the exterior. Obviously, you take it off before you start cutting, so the natural casing, what does that do for it? It's not synthetic. It's made from the intestines of a cow, and it just adds flavor. It keeps it natural, it keeps it longer, and it's just wonderful. And the flavor is just second to none. So that's our first ingredient. Then we use a Thumann's Canadian imported ham. And if you notice, there's basically very, very little fat. So although it's not labeled a low fat or a low salt ham, it's very healthy for you because it really is low salt and low fat just by the quality and the nature of what Thumann's does. They also are no MSG added to any of their products. So that's a big thing. Now here, Stocky, he likes to have a domestic hot ham on his hero sandwich.
The cavatappi is my favorite, also known as hot ham. It's my favorite, yes. It's Tony Soprano's favorite.
In here, most people come in and they'll say they want the imported cavatappi. And I think people enjoy letting you know that they know how to say it.
Right. So because if you say capicola, you're not Italian.
Right. It's cavatappi.
Cavatappi.
The cavatappi. Taking the cavatappi.
Let's get back to that cavatappi.
For the cavatappi.
The cavatappi.
Cavatappi.
Cavatappi. Over here.
The cavatappi.
Cavatappi.
All this from a slice of cavatappi.
Next is prosciutini, one of my favorites.
Yeah.
I think it's
pepper ham. Pepper ham.
It's a pepper ham.
Delicious.
Prosciutini, pepper ham. What I like about it, this is actually a pepper cavatappi, also a pepper on the outside, but this is a little bit more coarse, a little bit thicker, a black pepper, and it's delicious.
Delicious.
Again, the base of these are all ham, but the black pepper around it, it's prosciutini. So it's pepper ham, but it's prosciutini. The name gets confused sometimes with prosciutto.
Right.
But we make it clear to the customers which one they want. And it's awesome. It's awesome.
I have a friend who oftentimes confuses his prosciutini and his prosciutto. My friend Tom.
Yes. Yes.
Unbelievable. How could you not know your prosciutini from your prosciutto?
Right.
Tom.
Well, you can because you're a friend. But with a customer, we just say, no problem. Give it back to us. We'll make you another one.
Right.
And then we eat all the mistakes, so we don't really mind. And last, domestic provolone. We also serve a Recchio imported provolone in the store. But on a sandwich like this, the imported provolone, we feel overpowers too much. The smell and the taste. So the domestic provolone is made for sandwich. It's perfect with this combination.
And it's mild.
It's a nice, mild, smooth flavor. And it blends. It's awesome. And then for the grand finale, the little curve that Stocky throws into everything is our fresh mozzarella. We make this twice a day, 10:30 and 4:30 at Natoli's. Next, we're gonna go to toppings.
Well, if I may, you're forgetting one thing.
Yes, Stocky.
This is why Steve needs me.
I need the pepperoni. My man here. How did I do it?
I don't know.
I knew you were here for a reason.
You got it.
This is actually a Hormel pepperoni. It's a little more flavorful than the Genoa. It's not as smooth. It gives you a little jolt.
So and Steve knows.
Enjoy it.
If he leaves one ingredient off, I'll know it. I'll know it.
Stocky will know it. Right. Stocky will know. And I know I'm being put to the test when I make a sandwich for Stocky. No fooling around. And my guys all know as well. But he's a great guy and we want to please him. Can we go to toppings?
Please.
Okay.
Let's.
I want to start with these sun-dried tomatoes because it's something really special. Sun-dried tomatoes at Natoli's, if you notice, soft, beautiful. We blanch them in boiling water, take them out, dry them out, and then we add extra virgin olive oil, fresh garlic, fresh basil, and we don't use them for at least a week. So it really marinates in there, and I mean, it's soft. You could just fold it. You can't do that with the other sun-dried tomatoes. And when I put them on the sandwich with Stocky, we're gonna cut them in half because we don't want a big piece all going. We want this to be a blend of flavors that you like. Mm. And you always say you like that finished product to have one flavor, and that's what our goal was when we were making the sandwich for Stocky. Then we have hot peppers. These are hot cherry peppers. We cut them down for the sandwich. So again, we don't want any overpowering flavors.
Right.
We just wanted to give a nice flavor. And Stocky likes to blend all his toppings. So we have sun-dried tomatoes.
I don't like them to compete. I like them to complement one another.
Perfect. Well said. These are roasted peppers. We do extra virgin olive oil, fresh garlic, basil. A lot of delis won't do that because of the cost of extra virgin. But you know what? Quality doesn't cost, quality pays. And that's what we're all about. And Stocky holds me to the bar. Now we got sweet peppers. I'd love to say we do something to these, but we really don't. And I have to be truthful. So we just slice them up. But again, the hot, the sweet, the sun-dried, it's all getting crazy now. Red onion, delicious. Again, not overpowering like a white Spanish onion. Cut paper thin. We don't want any flavor being too strong. Beautiful, right guys? Look at that. Amazing. And then we get our basics, because we can't leave them out. Good old greens. So we have some nice shredded lettuce. We don't like to use leaf lettuce. We like it shredded, easy to eat, not overpowering. And beautiful tomatoes. Really, really beauties. And we just slice them. We're really into keeping everything right, so if you notice, they're all sliced the same width. And again, not too thick, so that they're overpowering. Not too thin, so they're like mouchard. You remember that word?
Yes.
No mouchard in Natoli's. Especially with Stocky Jockey. So, are we ready, Stocky?
I think we're ready.
Are we ready, Stocky?
I'm ready.
I'm ready too, baby. Very, very important. When you cut the bread, Stocky wants balance. So we make the top and the bottom the same width. If the bottom is too thin, it gets soggy. You go to pick it up, it falls apart. Stocky will say, "What'd Steve do to me here?" Can't have it, Stocky. So we're going right here. And I bend the knees a little bit, and I'm really taking my time, focus. If you ever saw me do the Macarena at a wedding, you'd know I can bend those knees, baby. This is a beautiful bread, by the way. Our bakery really did it special. I told them it was for Stocky Jockey.
Natoli's Italian Deli in Secaucus is the best Italian deli in the state of New Jersey.
Thank you, Stocky.
And for me to say that, I've been around. I've done my research.
And I am honored at that. Again, red wine vinegar, not balsamic. He doesn't want it to be too strong.
Steve and I met one another in a pizzeria.
Yes.
I knew the first time I met him, I said, this guy is gonna be a friend. He's gonna be a part of my life forever.
Amen. We have a lot in common. Now on here, I use a nice vegetable oil, salad oil, but not the extra virgin olive oil because it's just a little too strong. So we go with a good vegetable salad oil. Okay, every sandwich has to have a base, okay? So the base meat that we're gonna use is ham, actually. Ham is always a good base of a sandwich, but lettuce, I'm just spreading it out a little bit. Okay, that's enough there. On the top, we'll go heavier with the topping. But let's start with the ham. So we're gonna put the ham on the slicer. I've been cutting cold cuts for 43 years, so nobody has to be nervous. I like everything nice and thin, and you bunch it up a little bit. You can get this sandwich here 7 days a week.
And how much for the jumbo that you have?
The jumbo is $13.99. Two people can definitely eat off of it. You can't look at the size of the bread this way. You have to look at it this way when it's filled up with all the items.
And everyone has a different idea of, you know, serving size.
Yes, correct.
For me, this is for one.
Absolutely.
I rarely share, but you're my buddy, I love you, I'm gonna let you have a bite.
You know, when you grow up Italian, as you well know, food is the biggest part of your life, a very big part of your life. I shouldn't say the biggest, but very big part. Obviously, family, faith, first.
My grandfather, Peter Coppola, was born in 1905 in Sorrento, Italy. He came over here on the boat with his family at the age of four in 1909. And my grandmother, Anita Bello Coppola, was one of 13. And she lived in Hoboken. Her next door neighbor was Frank Sinatra.
Wow.
And she used to push Frank up and down the street in the stroller.
Oh boy. We have that in common too. Not the Frank Sinatra part, but my grandparents were from Hoboken as well. Well, Italy first and then Hoboken. They came over in 1907. My grandfather first, then he sent for my grandmother. I'm actually putting these on in an order that I feel will blend the best. You loving this?
I'm loving this.
Are you loving this?
You know what I'm really gonna
love? I'll stop if you're not loving it.
I'm gonna love it when I'm eating it. That's what I'm.
No doubt about it. Work can be fun when you love it, Stocky. Now we're going with this. Look at that. All thin, all just, when they're a little small, the slices, I hit them with an extra one. When we get new workers here, they said, do you have a portion control scale? How much do I put on? I said, make the sandwich like you're gonna eat it. Don't worry about how much you put on. And if you're not sure, put a little extra on. People could always take it off, but they don't have a piece in their pocket that they could put back in, right?
Sometimes I do put a little piece in the pocket, but.
Stocky, we're gonna have to count the pepperoni sticks before you leave.
You better.
I've made some sandwiches before, but none look like the Stocky Jockey. And I make some nice sandwiches.
43 years.
43 years. And I'm telling you that the Stocky Jockey, it might be the one. In the food world, the sandwich might be the one.
Prosciutini, not to be confused with a prosciutto.
Prosciutto. We're not even counting that half slice.
Just remember it's pepper ham.
Pepper ham. And of course, Thoman's.
They don't call it the deli best for nothing.
Amen to that. Hormel pepperoni.
Excellent. How amazing is the Stocky Jockey, Steve? It's all that and a bag of chips.
We opened up a nice provolone, domestic provolone.
I wish Natoli's was here when I lived in Secaucus.
Ah.
I lived in Secaucus when I was a little kid from, I guess, 4 or 5 years old till about 9.
Great town, right?
Great town, loved it.
What's missing, Stocky?
Fresh mozz.
The fresh mozz. Fresh mozz, made daily, not bought. And I mean, you're just gonna go crazy when you see this.
You know the famous commercial for Heinz ketchup, Anticipation? That guy's only waiting for a few seconds for his ketchup. You have no idea how this is driving me crazy. Talk about anticipation.
Anticipation.
But it's worth the wait. Steve likes to take his time, but I'll tell you what, we should have timed how long it took you to make the sandwich and how long it takes me to eat the sandwich. I bet I eat it faster than you made it.
Wow. Almost done.
The best.
Wow.
The best mozzarella you will ever have. I know food, and rarely do I go into a restaurant or a deli and say, you know what? These guys are doing everything right. They're knocking it out of the park on every level. They can't do it any better. And the first time I came in here, I said, these guys are doing it right. I always say my grandmother created the Stocky Jockey. My love of food, the passion that I have for food.
She did a good job.
Somebody ordered a Stocky Jockey.
You know who would have loved this sandwich?
Who?
Remember that show King of Queens? Doug yes. Heffernan?
And last. Sounds right, but what did we say we were gonna do?
Cut them.
We're gonna cut them.
To be part of a community for 43 years, to know that you're making people happy, to know that you have the best product, the best service, and you're giving people something amazing at a terrific price.
Not a lot, because we have it top and bottom already.
But it's just, all about balance, just like life.
Little love tap, just like life, Stocky. This, Stocky Jockey exclusive. This is Piedmont Bakery, by the way.
Where are they located?
They are actually located in New York. They were from Jersey, they're located in New York. You ready to take a bite?
Oh yeah, let's go for it.
Which one you want?
Which one do I want?
I'm going right out of my piece, Stocky.
Okay, I am gonna go for, I think, let's see, let's go for this one here.
Stocky?
Steve, thank you.
No, thank you.
Truly the ultimate Italian hero.
Wow.
The absolute best.
Stocky, give me a closing statement on this sandwich.
If you want the best Italian hero, you're only going to get it at one place. You just have to remember to order the Stocky Jockey. And like you said yesterday, you're ready, willing, and able. Bring your best game.
Bring your best game.
Bring your best game.
We'll try to match it in the Natoli's. One more bite. Oh.
Come down to Natoli's in Secaucus. You will not regret it. Everyone is super welcoming. They make you feel like family as soon as you walk in the door, and I think that's really important.
We have the Stocky Jockey coming out with the sandwiches.
Tastes like a little bit of Italy.
Yes.
The prosciutto, very nice. Mm. Earthy, sun-dried tomatoes, I can taste it. Provolone, mm-hmm. I love it.
This is awesome sandwich. Never had it before, but I had to try it because the description, the meats. Phenomenal blend, hearty. Bread is awesome, everything about it. Everything, all the toppings. The best deli sandwich I've had. Really awesome, thank you.
So I got a chicken cutlet, mozzarella, roasted red pepper, balsamic. And if I'm gonna rate a deli, especially an Italian deli, you wanna rate a chicken cutlet. Everyone wants to say they have a better one, but this one's perfect. It's thin, it's crisp, has a lot of flavor, and the bread is phenomenal.
Hey, I'm having a meatball sub at Natoli's, and I love it. It's delicious. It's got a lot of nice toasted bread, some good marinara sauce, over four meatballs. So it's just perfect. I mean, beautiful food, friends, happiness. Mwah!
Like your sweater, buddy.
I usually have the eggplant parm, which is amazing, but I decided to change it up tonight. I had a burger and fries, and it was delicious. The people that work here are so friendly, and the food is just always the best.
I had my favorite sandwich. It's a breaded chicken cutlet with fresh mozzarella, roasted peppers, arugula, and a little balsamic.
Everybody thinks you come to a place like this and you have to get something like a meatball parm or a chicken parm, but I like to switch it up, and the Greek salad's always a good way to do that.
Everything is just so fresh. Every time you come in, the quality is consistent. The breaded chicken cutlet is so thin, it's a perfect amount of crisp, and then they just stack everything perfectly.
The mozzarella cheese is freshly handmade, so it's awesome, and the balsamic dressing is to die for along with the bread.
I would say you have to come here and you have to try everything, because everything on this menu is amazing. So come to Natoli's.
We started here in 1977. I was in college at William Patterson College, and I couldn't get a job. I heard there was a store for rent in Secaucus, so I drove out here, met the landlord, shook hands immediately on renting the store out. The luckiest day of my life was when I drove into Secaucus. And on September 24th, I opened Natoli's Deli. Obviously, the business wasn't the way it is now. It was candy, it was a little deli action. My first cash register was this cigar box that I took from my dad, and this was it. This and a little Casio adding machine, and if I had a customer with more than five or six items and I used the adding machine, went in and out of here with some money, I was elated. That's how we built the business initially. And as 2-3 years went by, I was going into my senior year of college. And my mother and father were asking me, Steve, what are you gonna do when school starts? And I said, well, I'm gonna ask you guys to come and basically cover the store while I drive up Route 3 and go to William Patterson College. And I had great parents, and my mom and dad, my brother, they helped me and covered me whenever I had to go to school. And my girlfriend at the time, who is now my wife for 44 years, Lisette, helped me, supported me, was all in. So I had my parents, I had my brother, I had my girlfriend, and eventually my mother and father-in-law. I had one or two employees that would come after school, help me close up, clean up, and things were going great. But I had to tell my parents I didn't want to go back to school for my senior year, second semester. I only had 3 months to graduate. Today I look back on it, I don't know how they didn't want to strangle me. And maybe they did, but they didn't. So that being said, I tell my mother, of course, I didn't want to go to my father. I let my mother know, and my mother says, I think you have to tell Dad. I said, well, I was hoping you would do that. With that, of course, my mother always never said no to me. She says, okay, I'll speak to Dad. Friday night rolls around. We used to close at 7 o'clock. At that time, it was just a deli. There was no pizza, there was no prepared foods. So I get home, 7 o'clock from here, take a shower, and it's Friday night, I'm gonna go out, pick up my girlfriend and go out. I make it to the front door, I put my hand on the doorknob, and I hear my father, who was sitting in the reclining chair with the newspaper up, I hear the paper go down, and I hear him say, Steve, I wanna talk to you. And I went, oh my God, Mom told him. So I look over at my father, and I said, yeah, Dad, what's up? He says, Mommy says, you don't want to go back to school. I said, Dad, I really don't. He said, but you only have 3 months to graduate. I said, Dad, my heart's not in it. My heart's in the store. I love the store. Things are starting to pick up. So he says, Steve, I have one question for you. Do you think you could provide for a family with that store? I really thought about it for like 3 seconds, 4 seconds, and I said, Dad, I think I can. With that, he wished me good luck. He picked up the newspaper, and I ran out of the store as fast as I, out of the house as fast as I could. I couldn't believe that I was out of the house, first of all. Second of all, I realized the importance of providing for a family, what it meant to my father. And I realized that's all he thought about through raising my brother and I and supporting us and my mom, who was a stay-at-home mom, through his, I guess, youth and raising of two young boys, which eventually I had two young boys. And I had the good fortune of the store really picking up, but I realized I was gonna start having a family and things were gonna get more serious and responsibilities and providing. So the future looked like it was going towards prepared foods. I knew pizza was always something I wanted to do. From that, we evolved into pizza, pasta, prepared foods, breakfast, and that was the way we grew through the years. People would call, ask us, do you do this, do you do that? We always say yes, hang up the phone and figure out how we're gonna do it. A lot of companies in the area use us for catering. We have PSC&G and the New York Giants we had for 19 years, up until when the stadium was built. And we do work for Goya, Hudson County Motors,
at a lot of major companies in the area, and it's great. And we do it all from one roof. We give quality food, excellent service, and we try and do it at the fairest price we can. And we open the doors every morning like it's the grand opening. You know, you get one chance at a first impression. We try and give that first impression every day. Natoli's, because like a girl from Kansas once said, there's no place like home.
Come on down to Natoli's Deli.
Tell them Stocky Jockey sent you.